has been updated with a new quest.
We got our battle pace. There seems to be some alerts on. Let's check our extractors. Get some almost useful, useless or useful stuff. Let's put the new reactors back. No, not reactors, extractors, I might say. Check what saucy it is. This looks awful. And they're good invasions, there aren't. Go for this third vigor mod. Do we have anything here? We have armor. We don't have enough money to start crafting a new one. We have the right mag systems this time. Previously it was indeed mag prime systems that we had erroneously started the craft. So we need 25,000 for this, and how much for the Trinity? Not at 25,000. Then we need 5,000 for this, so we need at least 80,000 experience. No, not experience, credits. My mind is in the gutter. Was there something else I wanted to check? This is completed, but I don't have any slots for that. So what do we want to sell? We want to sell the worm. First later, I suppose. That's also death cube, but sniper rifle. Just pretend that isn't electricity damage, type, status effect, and critical chance, critical multiplier. So it's, I think this might be the most useful sentinel weapon. It can stay relevant in even higher level content, I suppose. So let's do that, and don't really have any mod slots free for those. So let's change to Loki. Loki, let's go do that vigor spy mission. yeah,
your mission is to break into
I'm currently in the
steal any intelligence files you
process
find.
Of changing my day and night cycle. Got to be the place where I felt like it's better if I stay up without going to bed abnormally instead of staying up until something like 10 a.m. and then going to bed.
Tenno, be on the
I took a
4-hour
nap and went to bed at 23 o'clock and woke up at 4. So now I should be looking at a more normal rhythm.
You're nearing the console. Trigger the alarms now and they will start destroying the data. That was a juggernaut. They were lured out by the death of infested. Lay low and it should go away, or amp up the fight to draw it out. Biosignatures detected. We've got infested incoming. Excellent work. A clean extraction with no alarms. The juggernaut has moved on. It's safe to proceed.
Like a spot where you can farm infinitely for EXP. We're not actually farming for EXP. We are farming for energy sphere drops, and hopefully when we get out from this vault we'll be able to keep passively from having the equilibrium mod equipped, and thus also have enough energy for running around invisible. For some reason there was tar on the floor. And no idea why, because I was invisible so they couldn't aggro at me. Maybe it was the security cameras that got them riled up. So that was silly.
Is nearby. If you trigger the alarms now, the enemy will start destroying data.
Because we got got killed, we need to do this manually.
They won't even know it's gone.
That was a decent amount of energy. And neural sense as well. So that's nice.
Target console is nearby. If you trigger the alarms now, the enemy will start destroying data. Extraction with no alarms. We have everything we came for. Get to extraction.
Seem to almost have enough energy regen with the ability on to maintain invisibility indefinitely, but not quite yet.
Mission complete. Excellent work, Tenno.
Visit the dojo, because I have that one format that I haven't yet spent. And we finished constructing the biotics lab, I guess. So, it looks like this. biotech is. Yeah, you gained medium restores from the dojo. And they're of course quite useful. We sort of skipped over this technology and got two large restores through the syndicate progression. But it's definitely nothing to sneer at. A lot of these crafts require mutagen mass, which requires 10 mutagen samples to craft and something like 35,000 credits total. So this is why the infestation invasions are so good. Or maybe you could also say claim that all the invasions are good because you can get those costly resources as a battle pay from running them. Instead of having to craft them, and because you can only keep crafting one of these at a time, then there are some recipes that require something like 8 or 10 times to have this mutagen mass. So the total crafting time for those is something like 9 days if you don't have spare ones. So ideally we'd want to maintain one of these being crafted at all times, but it's going to take some resources to do that. Acrid used to be the best secondary weapon in the game. Then they added damage 2.0 and it's no longer the best. But it's still very good. And it is something that I want to have, because of the pairing sequences augment card which can be put into Acrid, giving it the syndicate proc. It has been one of my go-to weapons on my main account before I started using Furies for convenience. Yeah, let's start researching the mutagen mass. Plastics for it. And how much is left for the way we wanted to research here? Axtiletto. Still so much time left. I'd want to start researching these as well, but again we are short on money. That's something we want to do. Then it seems like there's only one or two places to go for it. But I'm seeing a capture mission that gives the dead eye mod. So let's do that quickly. We already do have a dead eye mod, but additional one won't hurt us, and if we want to, we might be able to sell it to some other player. This should be a fast mission. Maybe we can do it in a scope of maybe two or three invisibilities.
You are here on a capture mission. You must find, capture, and extract our target. The capture target has vital information that we will need to extract. We need our subject brought back alive. You found a target. Capture them quickly before they escape.
Well, he started up pretty close at the beginning of the map.
Mission complete. The captive has been escorted to the extraction point. Well done.
So many cell arrays. Not that I'm complaining. Hearing the alarm ringing in a few moments. Normally, but because this is a capture mission and I've already captured the target, there's something like a persistent alarm going on, so maybe not.
Excellent work. We'll interrogate the captive back at base. Your part is done here, Tenno.
16,000 credits. I'm wondering... That seems to be something like... 11,000 more than the regular mission reward might be for this level's mission. So how much of... How many extra credits did it actually contain? Let's actually test out this theory. This one has a reward of 4,100, so if we run it and watch the end mission credits, then what kind of a sum are we looking at? It's something like 6,000 credits now, given how low level this mission is.
Mission is to break into enemy data vaults and steal any intelligence files you find. Increased security measures. The enemy would rather destroy their data than let it get into our hands. nearby. If you trigger the alarms now, the enemy will start destroying data.
I also find myself wondering if we gain the actual spy mission rewards for running this mission as well. And we have someone leeching our energy here. Is that that guy?
Excellent work. A clean extraction with no alarms. You're nearing the console. Trigger the alarms now, and they will start destroying the data. Heavy infestation ahead. Data extracted. They won't even know it's gone. console. Trigger the alarms now, and they will start destroying the data. Everything we came for. Get to extraction. Another job well executed.
8,200. And the bonus credits was 4,100 maybe. So that seems to be exactly half of this number. Is that how it goes? But we did not gain any other reward for this.